Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this session, we'll see about data scraping technique with the help of UiPath Studio. So if you see on my screen, I have some search results from Google. So here it is showing some top stories. So here in this example, I just want to extract all the titles from these top stories. So there are around 9 articles available here with the search term COVID testing. So with the help of UiPath, we'll see how we can extract these titles along with the URLs. So I have already created a flow with the help of data scraping. So this is the option available in the UiPath Studio. So, and I will show you how we can get the data once we use the data scraping technique into our notepad. So here I have extracted the URLs, all we have available in the top stories, and I copied all these details into this test from UiPath Studio Robot. Okay, so before starting the process, make sure you have the Chrome extension of UiPath available or not. So if not, how you can enable this is, so go to the tools and here you can see the UiPath extension. So just click on this Chrome and or Firefox, whatever the browser your system has. So click on that and install the extension. So once you downloaded the extension, extension will get enabled and it will be available in the Chrome or in your respective browsers. So after that, what you need to do is, so go to the UI Explorer. So here we can see a pop-up will be displayed for the UI Explorer here in this window. So we'll see one gear button here available, and here what we need to adjust is click on it and make it as UI automation. Okay, so just click the UI automation and close this, and now we can start the data scraping. So for starting the data scraping technique, so create a new process and click on the data scraping. So here a wizard will get open. So here we'll hit some instructions like open your browser application or document from where you want to scrap the data, and then click on the next button and then click on the field. So click on next, and so click on the element where you want to start the extraction of data. So here, as I want to start the data extraction from this top story, that is coronavirus ICMR issues advisory, so just click on it. That is the beginning point, and another wizard will get open, select the second element to create a pattern. So it will form a pattern here, so just click on the second element. So I just want to scrap the data till the third element. Okay, so now we'll get a new wizard saying the extracted elements. So first one is the text column, so which is having the name of the title. So here I will name it as title, and in the second column, so it is an extracted URL, so check this checkbox. So if you want to use the URLs as well in your process, so now I want to use the URLs as well, and I will rename this as URLs. Okay, just click on next. Now this will generate a new wizard with a data table, so which is showing the titles and the URLs. So here you can see the first title is saying as coronavirus ICMR issues advisory for use of Feluda paper scripts. Okay, so and for that same title we get the URLs here, so you can see it. And so we can adjust the maximum number of results. So as I have only 9 elements here, so it is below the 100, so there is no problem. Suppose if I want to extract more than the 100, so then we can give the number here. And if you want to edit the definition, you can edit here. So like this, by clicking on the edit definition, you can edit the definition and click on the finish. Now this will create a flow in the UiPath. So before that, here it is asking one more thing. each data spanning multiple pages required. So what it means is, here I don't need any data spanning. So here what the data spanning means, suppose if you see the results here for the COVID testing, suppose if I want to extract these titles, so like COVID-19 testing Wikipedia, coronavirus COVID-19, so all this information if I want to scrap from multiple pages, so that time we can use this is data scanning multiple pages required. So that time we need to select this thing, so it will capture the titles or the pattern whatever we have selected in the previous steps and copies the data from the all the pages. Okay, so as now I don't have multiple pages, so I am just selecting the no. So now it will ask for the sequence name. I'll give like this and just click on create. Now we can see a new sequence got created here in our UiPath Studio with the elements whatever you have selected in the extract structured data view. So here in the variables we can see a new variable is created, that is nothing but the data which we are receiving from the browser. So it is in the form of an extract data table. So here what I will do is, I will print the data into an Excel sheet first, and then we will see how we can print the data into a notepad. So for that I am going to use Excel application scope, as I want to work with Excel, so we need the Excel application scope. So here I have the Excel application scope, and just drag and drop into the designer panel, and we need to mention the path. So I will use the project folder location. So here I will mention the path in the double quotes. I don't have any sheet now, so I will just ask my robot to create a new Excel sheet. So I am giving the name as covidtest.xlsx. So this will create a new Excel sheet, and as it is a data table, I want to write the details in the form of range so that I can see the results from a particular point in my Excel sheet. So here we'll have the activity called write range. So we'll drag and drop into the Excel application scope here, and here it is pointing to sheet 1 and the range as A1. So I'll just keep it as it is, and here mention the data table what we are receiving from the data scrapping technique. Okay, and if we want to header information to be printed on the Excel sheet also, so you just need to click on this add header checkbox so that it will print the header information as well in your Excel sheet. So let's check now whether we are able to get the data from the particular Chrome browser or not. So execution is started. So while working on this data scrapping, please ensure your browser is open with the page whatever you have selected for the data scrapping. So the process is completed now, so we'll go to the path. So this is the folder location which we have provided. So here a new Excel sheet with the name COVID test is created. So let's open this. Yep, see, we got the data here. As you can see, the information title with the items around 10 count, and the URLs are also generated and copied into the Excel sheet from the range A1 to AB11. So we can see here. So in the next step, what we will do is, so I just want to display the URLs in a notepad. So for that, what I will do is, so I will take one for each row activity. So just I'll just search for each row. So here we have this for each row. So just place inside the designer panel. So here we need to take the data table as the input. So my data table is extract data table, and here the index, I will create one variable called row, so which points to the rows of each data table. And next activity what we need to do is, so get row item. So just drag and drop this get row item. So this activity get the data from a particular row which we specify based on a particular column. So here I want to extract the URLs. So here I will give the column name as URL in double quotes. Here the input for this get row item will be the row index, nothing but the row, and here it will generate an output which is stored in a variable called URL value. So now for every iteration, a new value will be generated from the URL column of my data table, and it will be copied into the URL value variable. So for printing the data into a notepad, I will use one activity called append line. So here we have the activity which is the system activity of UiPath Studio. So it will take the input of the text. So here our input is from the get row item, which is nothing but the URL value. And here we need to specify the file name. So as I don't have any file name created, so what I will do is, I will just provide the folder location and I will ask the robot to create a new file on its own. I will just provide the path along with the file name. So here I will just name it as covenews urls.txt. So this will create a new text file with all the URLs. As it is an append activity, it will append the data one by one. So here we can see in the execution. So I will run this now, and if you run this process again, the data which is available in the Excel application scope will get overwritten in the sheet 1 of A1 cell. So let's run this now. The execution is completed, and here in the folder location we can see two files. One is covidtest.xlsx and a covidnews urls text file is also generated. So let me open this. Here we can see the urls will get generated here, and in the covid test we'll have the data related to the title and as well as the URLs. So the same URLs whatever we received here, like the hindu.com, timesindia.com, hindutimes.com, news18mumbai.live, so all the information is available here. And if I rerun this again, the data which is available in the for each row will get appended, as we have used the append line activity. So it will be concatenated to the previous results. So I'll show you again. So I'm just running the execution again. So the execution is completed in 5 seconds. So if I open this COVID news URLs, so here we can see the data get appended to my previous results. So this is the first execution result. So the upper part is the first execution result. So we can see the same data duplicated available here. Okay. So whereas in Excel, the data will get overridden as we are not providing any new sheet 1 or column details in my Excel application scope. Okay. So like this, we can use this data scraping technique to get the text from the particular website or from a document. So, or if you are using any websites like e-commerce, suppose I'm using the Flipkart. Suppose if I want to see the prices or copy the brands from a particular search result, if I want to copy the details of the titles along with the prices which are available in the results, so I can also copy all these details with the help of the data scraping technique which is available in the UiPath Studio. And we can copy it into an Excel or into a Notepad or into a WordPress based on the requirement and based on the activities available in the activities tab. Okay, so that's all for this session. I hope you like this video. Please do subscribe and share this video with your friends. Thank you.